I want a youth for a title. The youth. Looking at the wrong paper. The you mighty men of valor. Hallelujah. This goes for women too. You mighty women of valor. You mighty men of valor. Hallelujah. God called Gideon. God will call Gideon. Out of oppression, out of depression, out of the rigor of the Midianites of the time. They were prevailing against Israel, stealing their flock and their wheat and their grain. They would be stealing it, making them overwork as the devil always does. He overworks us by placing bondages in our lives, by placing circumstances in our lives. Today, we can say that the church is in rigor through the bondages that have been placed on it. And what do you mean, the church? I'm not talking about the church that stands in the shed blood of the Lamb, but I'm talking about the modern church, the church of the day, the church that now become the club scene, the church now that looks like a community center, the church that no longer has a cross within their midst. That has hearkened to other spirits. As Timothy said in chapter 4:1. I'm going to go in. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time that you've given us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you still dwell in that tabernacle, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord, that you still dwell between cherubim and seraphim, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that blood still covers our broken law, Heavenly Father. We thank you that when you look down, Lord, you see nothing but the blood of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that you placed us in something powerful, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you placed us in your death and your resurrection, Heavenly Father. Give us the anointing and the power, Heavenly Father, to be more than overcomers through Christ Jesus, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord. Let us walk in Christ, Heavenly Father. Let us be who you are, Heavenly Father. Let us be walk in that power, that we may know the power of your resurrection. Oh, mighty men of valor. And if you find Gideon would be a prophet of the day. In the book of Judges, God would raise judges for his people. There was no longer, at the time, there would be no king reigning. Not yet, till David would come. But you find Gideon, and you find the media prevailing against him. As us sometimes, you feel the enemies within yourself prevailing against you. In the outer court, it would be a believer today fighting the good fight of faith, fighting bondages in your life, and you find yourself fighting bondages that you can't win. You find yourself facing giants that you can't defeat. You find yourself walking in water that you can't walk on, but you keep on drowning because your faith has been misplaced. Your faith has been misplaced. You see, we weren't born to beat the battle. We weren't placed to beat. To be in that arena and to win the fight, but he was placed in it. Hallelujah. I said he was placed in it. In that. He's the champion. Hallelujah. There is no champion in us. He's the champion. He defeated all principalities, powers, and dark places. So we can possess our victory. Hallelujah. Let me get into it. It says, and the ark. And there came an angel of the Lord and sat under an oak, which was in Ophrah. That pertained unto Joash and Abizarite, and his son Gideon threshed wheat by the windpress to hide it from the Midianites. Let me get into it. It says, Israel, God's chosen people, of their sin were hard put upon them to feed themselves, much less enjoy prosperity, because the enemy took everything they had. Hallelujah. How many of us are placed? How many of us are in that place where you feel that the enemies took in everything you had because you left the prescribed order of victory, because you abandoned the cross? When you abandon the cross, you have nothing but enemies upon you. You got nothing but a Midianites upon yourselves. If we could say that, Israel had turned to a state of apostasy, and I'm not giving the apostate church no glory because they destroy themselves. They destroy themselves. We don't need to talk about them. We don't need to gossip about them because they destroy themselves. But we are going to point the error. We are going to point that they're walking in the wrong direction. We are going to point that they're walking in that road towards destruction. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because narrow is the way. Hallelujah. I said narrow is the way that leads to life. Hallelujah. And broad is the way that leads to destruction. Hallelujah. You've been placed in the narrow way. Hallelujah. You've been placed in the narrow. Hallelujah. You know, there might not be a lot of followers. You might not get a lot of shouts. There might not be a lot of glory. Hallelujah. You might not get that many pads in the back. Hallelujah. But you're walking and you're talking in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah to the Lamb. We preach Christ crucified. Because he's the only solution.
Amen.
He's the only answer. Hallelujah. He's the only hope of glory. Hallelujah. From the manger to the cross. Hallelujah. He was born in the manger. Glory to God. Prophecy has been fulfilled. Hallelujah. There was Isaiah 53 had been fulfilled. It's the preachers of the day. It's the haters that... And men in the synagogue would look to the scroll. They would have seen that there was a baby birth going to be born. Hallelujah. A Savior. Hallelujah. A Savior of the world.
Lord,
hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. There was a Savior born. There was a Savior born. Hallelujah. There was a Savior born. And it wasn't the Pharisees and the priests and the manger. It was the three wise men that would take him the gifts and acknowledge him as Savior. You guys get a hold of that. It wasn't the church that went to exalt the Savior. It's not the church that's exalting the cross anymore. Hallelujah. You guys understand that? It is the wise men, hallelujah, bringing gifts. He said, we got gold. We got myrrh. Hallelujah. We got shackles. We got silver. We come bearing gifts. Hallelujah. Because the Savior was born. A Savior was born. Hallelujah. A Savior was born. And let me get into it. By the Midianites and the wine press to hid it from the Midianites. Israel would be in a state where they would hide. They were trying to hide their possessions from the enemy because it was getting devoured. As us sometimes, we hide behind this coat. We hide behind the dress. We put on our good Sunday outfit. And we say everything's good. Everything's good. And we hide because our bondages had overtaken us. But beyond the week, we're fighting a battle within our minds and our hearts and our souls that we're trying to live for God, but you find yourself always in defeat. That was the Israel of old because they had abandoned the sacrifice. They had abandoned the sacrifice. But God always raises a Gideon. Hallelujah. I say, God always raises a Gideon. Hallelujah. Let me go in. I said, then the angel of the Lord appeared unto him and said unto him, the Lord is with you, you mighty men of valor. Hallelujah. That's all Gideon had to see. You see, Gideon within himself, behind his oppression, behind the Midianites devouring the flock, he had to come to a place where he was in need of a Savior. You guys get that? He was in need of a Savior. And the Lord, you see, the Lord don't look at you when you're reprobate against him. The Lord don't look at you when you don't acknowledge what he did on Calvary. How the Gideon came to his senses. And all of a sudden, and the Lord, he said, and the Lord will say upon all you mighty men of valor, hallelujah. You don't have to fully understand the cross, but if you place your faith in what he provided for you, and the Lord looks down at you and he says, you mighty men of valor, hallelujah. And it's not because of your strength, because you place your faith into something mighty and great. Hallelujah. I feel that this morning. You place your faith into greatness. Hallelujah. And you can possess greatness through what Christ did. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I can feel his anointing this morning. He works the perimeters of the cross. God doesn't work outside Calvary. I say God don't work around outside of Calvary. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. You've done your good deeds. I'm happy for you. You handed out your sandwiches for the week. I'm happy for that. I praise you for that. But God don't work outside of Calvary. Hallelujah. My. You made a week in your 12-step program. 5, 4 times, 6 times this month. But God don't work outside of Calvary. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah for that. Hallelujah. Thank God. Thank God it was from my major to the cross. Hallelujah. 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 And Gideon said unto him, O Lord, if you be with us, then why has this befallen us? If you be with us. You see, God would have to chastise Israel for a moment. He would have to let the Midianites prevail against them. Why would the Lord let the enemies and the bondages of our lives, which were their enemies in the old covenant, but now they become bondages in a believer's life? Because after Jesus Christ, everything became spiritual. Everything's become spiritual. No longer do you gotta fight the Midianite. No longer do you gotta fight the Amalekite. No longer do you gotta fight the Jebusite, because David defeated them already. Hallelujah. The son of David defeated them already. Hallelujah. He came to set the blinded eyes to open. Hallelujah. He came to set those that were bruised at liberty. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And you feel the Amalekites. You feel the wrath of the Amalekites sometimes within yourself. Because you're not, this battle is not a flesh and blood, but it is a spiritual battle. Let me get into it. And Gideon, he'd be with us. And he would say, and where be all your miracles, which our fathers told us of saying? You see, that was an act of faith. That was an act of faith by Gideon. Where I'll be these miracles that I heard from my forefather, as some of us say. You find yourself in a battle and you say, Lord, I need to see over for me today. If this biblical is right, if what you say in the gospel is right, if you say there's healing, divine healing in this book, if you say there's deliverance in this book, in the shed blood of the Lamb, why am I getting my breakthrough? Because your faith has been misplaced. It's no longer on the shed blood of the Lamb. It's went somewhere else. So he's let the Midianites prevail against you and devour your stocks. What are you saying, devour my stocks? He's devouring you spiritually. There is no victory in your life. You try to find different ways of success within yourself because you haven't found it. You haven't found it. You haven't found that victory. You've took on every teaching that they had to teach. You took on the Hebrew movement. You took on, I've been a champion. You took on, let me find my purpose. You took on every teaching that was out there, but you still not found your victory. Why is that? Why is that? Because man don't have victory. Hallelujah. I said man don't have victory. Hallelujah. But every victory was placed around the Lamb of God. Every victory was laid upon this Lamb that was to come to die without a spot or a blemish. Hallelujah. And bruise his head and bruise his heel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, we could say Gideon could be in a place of those believers that are looking to God and saying, where are the miracles? Where are your wonders? Where is your power? Because that's where I was at one time. I said, Lord, if you're real, I've heard about you. I've heard about my fathers opening the Red Sea. You know, I ain't Hebrew, but I've been adopted into it. Hallelujah. I've been adopted into greatness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I've been adopted into Judah. Hallelujah. Let me go on. Did not the Lord bring us out from Egypt? But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us into the hands of the Midianites. This oppression that breathed in every word of the spoken by Gideon, the oppression that was laid upon Gideon upon this day, can you imagine that? Him telling the Lord, I know you're the God that split the Red Sea. I know you're the God that gave Abram that your seed shall bless the world. I know about this. I know about Egypt being stricken by the shed blood of the Lamb. I know about Moses striking that doorpost with that hyssop and the shed blood of the Lamb and the Paschal Lamb that was eaten and the leavened bread. I know about that. Then why are we in this place of bondage? And you ask yourself today, why am I in this place of bondage? Why? Because they abandoned the sacrifice. When you abandon sacrifice, there's nothing but bondage there. Whether you admit it or not, there will be nothing but bondage, and the Lord will cause this bondage upon you. Why? Why would you say the Lord be so harsh upon a believer? Because you abandoned his way. You abandoned his statutes. When you said, when you placed your faith in that shed blood of the Lamb, you said, I no longer live for me, but I live for you, hallelujah. You said, no longer do I walk after the sin. You said, I hate that, what I do. There's too many believers now that like sin. They enjoy sin. But there are some that hate sin. There are some. There's some, I feel that. There's some Pauls out there that say, I hate sin. There's some Pauls out there that say, sin will not have dominion over me because I'm not under law, but I'm under grace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There's some believers out there that will say, the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set me free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for that. Hallelujah to the Lamb. There's not many, but that's all right. God don't work in the many. God works in the supernatural. Hallelujah. He only needs one vessel. Hallelujah. Just stand up and say, let my people go that they may serve me. Glory to God. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Glory to God. Glory to God. I feel that. But now the Lord has forsaken us and delivered us into the hand of the enemy. If we were to talk about this, we'll say the Lord's delivered us into our bondages. Into our bondages. What are bondages? Alcoholism. Pornography. Whatever your bondage is, adultery, fornication, whatever bondage is upon you, is there to press you. It's there to press you to a turning point. Hallelujah. It's there to press you to a turning point. Hallelujah. It's there to make you turn from your evil ways. Hallelujah. Thank God he allows this. Thank God he don't just say you're full of bondage and I'm going to cast you away. But no, he said, I'm going to place this bondage upon you and you're going to turn to me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He placed a circumstance upon us. It wasn't a coincidence that Israel was so full of bondage, the rigor that was placed upon them, to a point where they cried out to the Lord. And that's when he can hear you, when you cry out. Because when you cry out, you came to a place of repentance. You came to a place where you turned from your wrongdoing. Hallelujah. Let me go in. And the Lord looked upon him and said, Go in your might, and you shall save Israel from the hand of our Midianites. I have sent you. Hallelujah. Amen. I have sent you. The Lord has given this ministry a commission. Hallelujah. I said, the Lord is with you. Hallelujah. Cross the Calvary. The Lord is with you. I have given you, God, this commission. You understand that? Hallelujah. I feel that this morning. It doesn't matter what a costly church is like for. It doesn't matter who comes here and tries to destroy the message of the cross. That don't matter. What matters is that the Lord is with this ministry. Hallelujah. I feel that. The Lord is with this ministry. The same Lord that struck Pharaoh. Hallelujah. The same Lord that told Peter, come out and walk on water. The same Lord, hallelujah, that healed the leper. The same Lord that opened the eyes of blind Bartimaeus is with us tonight, this morning. Hallelujah. 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 I said the Lord is with us. The Lord is with us. The Lord is with us. When you think we ain't gonna make it, remember, the Lord is with you as he was with Gideon. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for that. Let me go a little further. Let me go a little deeper. And he said unto him, O my Lord, where shall I save Israel? You come to a place of sarcasm. You see, he looked at the impossible. Hallelujah. He looked into the impossible instead of looking to the possible. Hallelujah. And that's what we do. We look into what we can't. We look into the circumstance that we say, Lord, we can't possess the land. Hallelujah. And God, you see, it's not in our power and our might because he's defeated the man And he said unto him, oh Lord, how shall I save Israel? Sarcasm, sarcasm. And some say, how will the cross deliver for me? You know, I have people literally saying, how is the cross? And then they put up crosses upon their houses and say, how can the cross deliver me? That's funny. How is the cross going to deliver you? Because he delivered, hallelujah. He delivered man 2,000 years ago. He delivered man 2,000 years ago before that. He delivered man another 2,000 years before that. Abraham was in a place called paradise by faith, hallelujah, because he believed in this shepherd of the Lamb. Hallelujah. That's how he's going to save you. That's how the Lord saves. The Lord saves, the Lord heals, and the Lord delivers. Hallelujah. Thank God for that. Thank God he's in the healing business. Thank God, hallelujah. Maybe he couldn't make it to that pool of Bathsheba. Hallelujah. You were crippled as that man, but he was dragging himself into that pool. And all of a sudden, everybody beat him to the situation. Everybody beat him when the waters were moving. Hallelujah. Maybe you're saying, Lord, turn my waters one more time. Hallelujah. Turn my waters one more time. And maybe you feel in that state that you can't make it. But Jesus Christ came to that crippled man and said, get up. He's moving waters right now. Hallelujah. I said he's going to move the waters. He's troubling waters. He's troubling waters right now. Hallelujah. He's troubling waters as we speak. He's making people look to those waters. Hallelujah. The waters are being troubled right now. Hallelujah. And if you effort to go to Calvary, if you even put your faith in there at what we minister a little bit, if you believe as a grain of a mustard seed, he will come to you. He will come to you. He will come to you. Hallelujah. Thank God. Thank God. You know, that pool, the Holy Spirit will trouble. And as people will place themselves in that pool, healing will take place. Deliverance will take place. And then that crippled man had no way to make it. Every time he seen the pool be troubled, he couldn't make it to the pool and get his healing. And maybe that's you today. You're saying, I can't make it to the pool. Hallelujah. I can't make it to the pool. But if you come to me, Jesus, I believe. I believe if you come to me, he will. He will come to you. Hallelujah. He will. He's in the will business. Hallelujah. He's in the will. He's not forsaking you, but you're forsaking him. Hallelujah. Oh, my mind. You see, Israel was defeated by that Midianite at the time. But God never left them, hallelujah. I said, God never left them, hallelujah. Because he told Gideon, get up, you man of valor, hallelujah. Get up, you mighty man of valor. He didn't just say man, he said mighty man of valor, hallelujah. Get up. And that's what he's telling the church today. He's saying enough is enough. You've been defeated by those Midianites, the Canaanites, the Jebusites defeated you too long. You've been in bondage too long. He said, it's time to get up now. It's time to start looking to Calvary. It's time to place your faith in what I provided for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank God for God. Let's go in a little more. And he said, oh my Lord, sarcasm, how shall I save Israel? They're alone. He was probably thinking, I can't save myself. I can't heal myself. I can't deliver myself. How can I save Israel? Could I save Israel? Behold, there's a family that is poor in Manasseh. Hallelujah. And I am the least in my father's house. I'm the least. This reminds me of King David. I'm the scrawny one. I'm the one that tends to the sheep. Hallelujah. And God don't look at that. You see, God don't look at the natural. Like I said earlier, he looks. Because he operates in the supernatural. Hallelujah. You see, David didn't need Saul's armor. Hallelujah. I said, David, you see, the church is trying to wear Saul's armor right now. They're trying to win this battle in the flesh. But this battle can only be won in the spirit. Do you guys understand that? Hallelujah. Because the stone symbolized grace. Hallelujah. The Holy Spirit led that rock straight to that giant's head. Hallelujah. You can't win this battle without the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. We can't. This is a battle that man can't win. You'll find yourself in the place of the old Israel of old, getting defeated by the Midianites, prevailing against you. Why would the Lord do that? He would be for the tribe of Manasseh, one of Joseph's sons. I am the least in my father's house. That was the reason God picked him. That was the reason that God picked him. You guys get that? He was the least in his father's house. He was from the tribe of Manasseh. You see, this wasn't Judah. This wasn't Levi. This man wasn't even called. He was from the tribe of Manasseh. He wasn't even in the priestlyhood. But you see, God looks beyond your qualifications. Hallelujah. I said, God looks beyond your qualifications. You might not have went to Bible college. You might not have went here and there. But you might not even belong to a big denomination. And God has called this ministry to preach Christ and him crucified, because he qualified us. Hallelujah. 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 And the Lord said unto him, surely I will be with you, and smite the Midianites as one man. The Lord being the key alone. Let's read that passage again. Surely, surely I will. Surely I'll be with you. Surely I will be with you. Hallelujah. Surely I will be with you. And you shall smite the Midianites as one man. You see, the power wasn't in Gideon. The power wasn't in Gideon. Hallelujah. It was a power behind Gideon. Hallelujah. Or in front of Gideon. Hallelujah. It was the same power that walked around Jericho 7 times and the walls of Jericho came down, crumbling down. Hallelujah. Because the angel of the Lord stood upon those walls. Hallelujah. No walls in the people's out of the promised land. Hallelujah. No devil in hell in the people's out of the promised land. Hallelujah. Because the walls that came down. The walls came down. Let's go in. And he said unto him, if you not found grace in your sight, show me a sign. You talk with me. You see, Gideon was trying the Lord. You see, Israel were no fools. They knew the sacrificial system. They knew that it was given to Abraham. They knew that they would go away from it. They would apostatize. They would turn to other gods. They would turn to unclean gods. They would turn to Baal, to Dagon. They would start human sacrificing to their gods, which was abhorrent to the Lord. The church knows what's right, and they know what's wrong. But it seems to be that they want to worship the way they want to worship. They want to please God the way they want to please God. But you can't please God out of Calvary, because it pleased God not to spare his own son. Hallelujah. Nailing him to that cross. Let's go in. And Gideon, depart not hence, I pray you, until I come unto you. Bring forth my present. Depart not hence, I pray you, until I come unto you. Bring forth my presence. My present. Present. A sacrifice. And I said before you, and he said, I will tarry until you come again, until you come with the sacrifice. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You see, the Lord will wait for you. You see, he's patient. He's not like us. He don't give up on man. Hallelujah. You see, we give up on people sometimes. We count them out sometimes. We'll say it. They didn't make it. But the Lord is still waiting for him. Hallelujah. I feel that this morning. I said the Lord is still waiting for him. He's waiting for Gideon to come back after the kid goat. Hallelujah. You see, a kid goat symbolized the shed blood of the lamb, a sacrifice. You see, to your plate, the Lord is waiting for you today. I said the Lord is waiting for you today. But you got to come with a sacrifice. You got to come place your faith into the shed blood of the lamb, because that's what he required of us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let me get the story gets better. This is my favorite part of the book. Because it speaks about Calvary. I said it speaks about Calvary. It speaks about what he's done for me. Hallelujah. It gives me joy when I think about what he's done for me. It gives me joy. Why? It gives me joy unspeakable and full of glory. Why? Because I know there was a debt. Hallelujah. I know there was a debt paid. Hallelujah. that my punishment's been canceled. Hallelujah. I said, I know that my punishment's been canceled on Calvary's tree. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go in. Gideon went and made ready a kid. This will speak of a young lamb for a sacrifice and 11 cakes of an ephah, a flour. This was a thanksgiving offering. So he comes with the lamb for the forgiveness of his sins. Hallelujah. He comes with the 11 bread for thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord. I come with the forgiveness of my sins, Lord. I come in repentance. Now I come to thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. It's not hard, church. I said it's not hard. Maybe you're saying the Lord's not accepting me. Maybe you're saying I'm not inheriting these promises. Maybe you're saying I'm not inheriting these promises that were given to Abram. It's not hard. Just go get your kid, go. He's waiting. I said go get your kid, go. He's waiting. Hallelujah. Go get those 11 breads ready. You come with your repentance offering. Hallelujah. You come with your thanksgiving offering. Hallelujah. And he shall forgive you because he's just. Because he's just. Hallelujah. He's a just God. He's a just God. Hallelujah. He works in the just. Can you guys understand that? I said he works in the just. He's in the justifying business. Hallelujah. He's in the forgiveness business. Hallelujah. He's in the forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. Let's go in. So Gideon. You see Gideon. The Lord will look down on him. Something in Gideon's heart was looking for an answer. Something within his heart was in repentance of his wrongdoing. Next, the Lord gives him a promise. The Lord gave him a promise. Now Gideon will come with what the Lord required of him. Hallelujah. You can't receive a promise without the sacrifice. There is no promise outside of Calvary. Do you guys get that? You guys get that this morning? I said there's no promises outside of Calvary. These promises were based on the shed blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Every time Abram got a promise, he sacrificed. And the covenants got better and better. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said the covenants got better. You're in better prophets. You're in better promises. You see, in the old covenant, what I'm preaching right now, it was a shadow of good things to come. Hallelujah. I said it was a shadow of good things to come. It was a demonstration. It was a symbol of what Christ was going to do in Calvary. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. So here comes Gideon. The flesh he put in a basket. And he put the broth in a pot. And he brought it out under an oak. And presented it. You see, you got to present it. He presented, Lord, you don't got to go through the trouble of go slaying the lamb anymore. You don't got to go to the trouble of cooking the unleavened bread no more. You don't got to go to the trouble. All you got to do is believe. Hallelujah. You walk by faith now. Hallelujah. You're in a better covenant now. The work is done already. Jesus Christ came down from heaven, bankrupt in heaven. Hallelujah. Became the high priest and atoned, shedding his blood of the lamb upon that tree, becoming that ultimate sacrifice. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for that. Hallelujah for that. And the angel of God said unto him, take the flesh, take the unleavened cakes, and lay them upon his rock. Pour the broth. And he did so. The rock all of a sudden became the altar. Hallelujah. That's what we ought to look for. You got to look for the rock. Hallelujah. Some of us need to stand upon the rock one more time. Glory to God. You see, God don't work. You see, all of a sudden this rock became his altar. Hallelujah. Hallelujah for that. Praise God. Let me finish this. I'm running out of time. And the Lord put the end of his staff. You see, this was a pre-incarnated Christ that was showing. What I was showing Gideon, what he required. You guys understand that? This was Christ before. This was Christ as he resurrected. Hallelujah. You see, when Christ died on Calvary, he became, the Holy Spirit resurrected who he was. Hallelujah. Because he is and he was. Hallelujah. You see, Jesus Christ, he is. He's the beginning. He's the author and the finisher of our faith. He was before the foundations of the world. Hallelujah. So this pre-incarnated Christ was shown to him. He was shown to him. Bring the rock. And the rock became the altar. And the angel of the Lord put the end of the staff that was in his hand and touched the flesh and the 11 cakes. And there rose up a fire out of that rock. Hallelujah. I said there rose a fire out of that rock. Hallelujah. We need a fire upon the rock one more time. Church. Hallelujah. That rock, you see Gideon, that rock became his church at that time. Hallelujah. That rock became the altar. Hallelujah. We need the fire of God to dwell upon that rock one more time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Praise God. Thank God. Thank God. The Holy Spirit will consume upon this sacrifice. Hallelujah. This was a token being accepted by God. Hallelujah. You see, it was a token. Us sacrificing the old covenant was a token of the good things to come. It was a token unto God that we were going to accept what he was going to do on Calvary. Hallelujah. And the sacrifice. The Holy Spirit consumed the sacrifice. You, church, we want the presence of God. Church, we want the Holy Spirit. Bring your sacrifice. Hallelujah. Bring your sacrifice. You want victory over your life? Bring the sacrifice. You want healing upon your body? Bring the sacrifice upon the rock. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what we need. We need to bring the sacrifice upon the rock one more time. Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Glory to God. And he consumed the sacrifice and he finished up. And Gideon perceived that he was the angel of the Lord. All of a sudden, Gideon realized, this must be the Lord. This must be the Lord. He descended with the Lamb. Hallelujah. I said he's descended with the Lamb. Hallelujah. This must be the Lamb of God that taken away the sin of the world. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah for that. Hallelujah for the Lamb. Hallelujah for the blood. Thank God for the Holy Spirit. Thank God he's still consuming upon our altars. Hallelujah. Thank God he's still consuming in power and in might upon our altars. Hallelujah. Let's go into it one more time. I have seen an angel of the Lord face to face. Hallelujah. What does it sound like? I have seen an angel of the Lord face to face. It sounds like Moses when he was in the mountain. He only seen the backside. But Gideon got to see him face to face. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He became real to him because he brought what God could only receive. And that's the shed blood of the Lamb. Let's go into it. And the Lord said, peace be unto you. Fear not, for you shall not die. Peace be unto you. Why? Why was there peace in the midst of Gideon? Why was there peace upon Israel again? Why? Because he had brought the peace offering. Hallelujah. He had brought peace between man and God. Hallelujah. You see, God don't work outside the peace offering. You guys get that. There was peace. There was unity again, if we could say. God have visited man. Hallelujah. You shall not die. You shall not die. And Gideon built an altar there unto the Lord and called it Jehovah Shalom. The Lord is my peace. Hallelujah. Build the altar. You want peace? Build the altar. You want that oppression to go away? Build the altar. You don't want to be in bondage to sin no more? Build the altar. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I feel that this morning. Place your faith into Christ and Him crucified. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You want peace. We want peace. We want his healing. We want his deliverance one more time. We want the Spirit of God to come upon us one more time like he did in the days of Pentecost. We want Pentecost one more time. Put our faith in Calvary. Hallelujah. Worship to make your way back. Oh, you mighty men of valor.